only a vlog, but perhaps it's interesting to show how I make my radio coils, and especially with very, very thin wire like this. You have, say, at the edge a very thin wire, but I solder it to a stranded wire, and that stranded wire has to be sloppy enough to pick up the movements of that ape hair wire. When that's not done, it will break off, and that's the reason why I found here, not the reason, but anyway, I found this bunch of wire. I don't know where it came from, but anyway, it is soft. It has approximately, say, inside 5 strands of a massive copper wire, and it's very soft, malleable, etc., etc. And that's the reason why I use it here for this coil. I have to take perhaps my looking glass to show that better. This is, by the way, the gypsum model gips. In very, very old books, 1920s, it was described as plaster of Paris. But anyway, you can mix the gypsum with the polyester resin to any, say, paste that you need. Could be a very sloppy paste, more fixed paste, and in this case I use, here is that coil, by the way, and in this case I used this gypsum mixed with polyester resin, and of course you need hardener, but I don't want to get in details. Mix the resin with plaster here to the paste that you like. And I need now, say, to fix these wires with the connected ape hair wire to the, say, the fundament, the fundamental part of the carbon tube here. And also here we have exactly the same kind of plaster that is in a certain way movable. It must act like a kind of slime. And of course, with hardener attached to that sloppy paste, it will harden out and fix all the wires properly. That will surely be the case. 300 windings in both of the coils, etc., etc. So that was more or less all to tell. With the mixture of the gypsum and the polyester resin and the hardener, you can make a kind of mastic that will fit to many, many good properties in radio experiments.